friendship. And thank you all for taking your time to be with us today to celebrate Vale Youth Speak Up's achievements. My name is Jessica Freddy and I am an ambassador for Wales for the Febuary Awards. I would like to open tonight's presentation with a few words about the Philip Bronze Awards Network as a past winner and a national judge.
No.
The Philip Bronze Awards Network, led by Frances Lawrence, has been championing a belief in young people to achieve great things for 15 years. It has also achieved great things itself in helping young people to turn their lives around, in helping young people to build bridges and cross divides, and in helping young people believe in themselves, as I can personally testify. The Philip Lawrence Awards Network will always have young people at their heart, taking their ethos and inspiration from the words of Philip Lawrence, "Every child is capable of greatness." Without further ado, I would like to introduce our next speaker, a man whose claim to fame is accidentally spilling a drink over Pierce Brosnan, and whose nickname is Katie. Please welcome our Children's Commissioner, Mr. Keith Towler.
Well, good evening everybody. Yes, I did manage to spill a drink over Pierce Brosnan, and he was playing James Bond at the time, but he didn't have a gun on him at the time, frankly. I didn't realise it was Pierce Brosnan. He was much taller than me, but he wasn't as handsome as me, so I felt reasonably okay. Can I just say that it's absolutely fantastic for me to be here this evening for a number of reasons, really. My job as the Children's Commissioner is to make sure that everybody listens to what children and young people think and feel. Yeah? To try to do everything that we can to promote really positive environment for children and young people to grow up in Barry, in Wales, in the whole of our country. It's fantastic to see the Philip Lawrence Awards recognise what's going on here in Barry. They're absolutely brilliant. I couldn't be prouder of everything that's gone on here this evening, because it's so important. Yeah. You know, when we think about the words of Philip Lawrence, you know, that every child is capable of greatness, it's so important that we recognise that every single day. And there are two things that I represent, I suppose, as the Children's Commissioner.
Yeah.
One is children and young people. It's a fantastic honour for me to represent children and young people. And the other thing I represent is something called the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. Yeah. The UNCRC, yeah?
It's a mouthful.
It is a mouthful, you're absolutely right. It's a huge mouthful, and there's a key part of that called Article 12, which is that all of us should make sure that every child and young person has the right to speak up on any issue that affects them. So when you win this award for doing a film like that, that recognises how important it is that children and people with disabilities are embraced and welcomed and a part of our community, that's you speaking up and me applauding you. Absolutely. Many, many years ago, I used to work for an organisation called NACRO, which is really, really strange for me to be part of this today. And I was working at NACRO when we heard what happened to Philip Lawrence. And I can't believe that I have the most incredible honour of introducing to you Mrs. Frances Lawrence to come and talk to us now about the Philip Lawrence Awards and the significance of this event. I'm so pleased she's here. I'm so pleased that the award is making a difference in Wales. I'm really proud of you for winning the first one here. Absolutely, couldn't be prouder. Fantastic to see Jane Hunt here as your Assembly Member representing you. Can't be pleased, but the honour of introducing Frances Lawrence to you is a fantastic thing for me to do. So let's hear it for Mrs. Frances Lawrence.
Thank you, all of you, every one of you, very much for having us
me to be back in my homeland of Wales. I miss it very much and I don't get back here as often as I'd like. I lived in Swansea until I was about your age, about 17. And I used to come to Barry Island for a treat, for a very special treat. But it's a much bigger treat for me to be here today and to meet all of you. Thank you. Now the story of the Philip Lawrence Awards began some time ago, actually quite a long time ago now, when some of you perhaps were not even born. And you've probably been told a little bit about it now. How we want to show to the wider world the amazing things that young people do and to provide a platform where they can share their thoughts about problems in their communities and where they can showcase their solutions and, most importantly, where they will be taken seriously by those who have the power to implement change. And so I'm absolutely delighted that the Minister and the Children's Commissioner are here. Because one of our chief objectives in setting up the Philip Lawrence Awards was to bring young people, politicians, closer together to show that they are equally important. You're all equally important. And that you should all have an equal voice. Well, I thought that this evening, as being in Wales is so very personal to me, I thought perhaps I'd tell you a little bit about Philip Lawrence, what he was like as a person, and not just as a figurehead, as a symbol of these awards, not just as a name. But it's really difficult, isn't it, to sum up a person. There are so many elements to each one of us. I know a little bit, just a little bit, about some of you wearing those wonderful white hoodies. Yes. Because I've been watching you, I've been looking at you on YouTube. You've been doing some really great acting. I particularly liked the wall.
Which of you did the wall?
Yes.
Show me your wall.
Yes. And so I learned a little bit about what you thought of yourselves when you were doing it and how you summed yourselves up. And of course, we've just seen our film, The Mind's Fighters, which I think is fantastic and which should be shown to so many people across the country.
Around the world.
Around the world. And if I've got anything to do with it, then it will be. And in a few minutes, we're going to see another short film that we've made about you. Anyway, to go back to Philip, what can I say about Philip? He had a great sense of humour. He loved music and the theatre, and he absolutely loved this beautiful land of Wales. We lived here for a couple of years, and our first child was born here. And whenever we were here, Philip wanted to stay longer. And above all, Philip was interested in people, whoever they were, whatever their background, whatever their circumstances, whatever they were like. He'd spent hours talking, Philip was a head teacher, and he'd spent hours talking with his students about their lives and their hopes, their problems and their dreams. And you know, he would greatly have enjoyed meeting all of you. And his overriding aim was to help young people develop their full potential. And he refused